Installing a NAS is actually a lot easier than you can imagine. In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to set up and install a NAS along with its dedicated operating system, DSM, and basic configurations. Here we are going to unbox a DS1019 Plus. After taking it out of the box, please check if it comes with the following components: 1 AC power cord and adapter, installation guide, 2 RJ45 LAN cables, hard drive tray keys, and 2.5-inch hard drive screws. Before connecting to your NAS, you need to install hard drives first. Pull out the drive bay, remove the fastening panels from the sides of the drive tray, place the drive into the drive tray, and then insert the fastening panels to secure the drive in place. If you're using 2.5-inch hard drives, you need to use the 2.5-inch hard drive screws to secure the drives. To learn more about hard drive compatibility, please visit the link in the description to check the full compatibility list on Synology website. Insert the drive tray back into the drive bay until you hear a click when the tray is locked into place. You can use the key to lock the tray to prevent pulling out the hard drive during operation. Connect the AC adapter to the power port of the NAS and use the LAN cable to connect the NAS to your switch, router, or hub. Please make sure your NAS and laptop are connected under the same domain. Now, press the power button to power on your NAS. To find your NAS via Web Assistant, enter the following URL on your browser: find.synology.com. If the NAS is connected to the same domain, your DS1019 Plus will be found. If you cannot find your NAS with Web Assistant, please visit the link in the description to download Synology Assistant from Download Center. Click Setup to enter the DSM installation page and click Install Now. Please note that all the data in your hard drives will be erased. Click OK to install DSM. During the installation process, please do not switch the power off. The NAS will restart automatically right after the installation, and you will hear a short beep when it's done. Now you have to create your DSM administrator account. Enter the server name, username, and password. You need to use these credentials to log into your Synology NAS and its corresponding services. Click Next and select an update frequency you prefer. It's recommended to automatically install the latest DSM version to make sure your NAS is always up to date. Click Next. Click Skip this step for now, and we will explain how to set up Quick Connect later. Click Yes, and the DSM installation is now complete. Click Go to start using your NAS. If you're using the NAS for the first time, you need to create a volume to store all the packages and files. Here we're going to create one using Synology Hybrid RAID or SHR. If you want to know more about storage pools and volumes, please visit the link in the description. Open Storage Manager and select Volume on the menu. Click Create and follow the instructions from the wizard. If you need to manually select the RAID type, please select Custom, or you can select Quick to maximize storage capacity with SHR. Click Next. If you have 4 or more hard drives, select SHR2 to provide 2 drive fault tolerance. Click Next. Then select the hard drive you wish to create the volume with and click Next. Please make sure you understand that all the data from the selected hard drives will be erased and click OK. Now you will need to select a file system. BTRFS is recommended because it can provide more advanced features to your NAS. Click Next and Apply to finish the settings. Once the volume creation is complete, the system will automatically run a parity check and you can still use your NAS without any interruptions. Now we will guide you through how to set up a Quick Connect ID to connect your NAS without complex network configurations. To get started, you need to have a Synology account. You can register anytime from account.synology.com. With a Synology account, you will be able to access all Synology-related services in one portal. Go to Control Panel, Quick Connect, enable Quick Connect, and log into your Synology account. Enter your preferred Quick Connect ID and click Apply to finish the settings. Now you can access your NAS anytime and anywhere with this Quick Connect ID. Synology NAS is an all-around solution for all your storage needs. Open Package Center, where you can find and install a variety of packages such as backup, collaboration, multimedia, and so on. Besides Package Center, you can also download the corresponding mobile apps via Google Play and App Store. With your Quick Connect ID, you can connect to your NAS and access all the services and files anytime and anywhere. We hope you enjoy the installation of NAS. To learn more about Synology NAS, visit the links in the description.